the east side of Lake Miccosukee is drying up. The water's not low enough for us to come face to face with the forces that created it. Lake Miccosukee is the largest of the Red Hills region's natural lakes. We want to know where its water's going, and geologist Harley Means is going to show us.
So all this area around here is somewhat unstable, so watch your footing. We're in the Lake Miccosukee Basin. You're looking out across a sinkhole that is active right now and is taking lake water. So the lake is draining. You can actually see the high water mark on many of the trees out here. So you can see how low the water level is. But we've actually been in a deficit for rainfall. We really just haven't had much rainfall at all. So the combination of, you know, low rainfall coupled with the sinkhole activity in the bed of the lake is causing this lake basin to drain. So I define activity as anytime you've got active subsidence where you can actually see the ground surface is subsiding down into the void space that's down deep in the underlying limestone.
Harley really notices this kind of activity when we visit the second sinkhole.
This sinkhole was actually expanded quite a bit since I was here just maybe 10 days ago. And for instance, this tree right here wasn't in and it is now. You can see all the roots hanging. I can tell that both of these waterfalls are actively cutting back, enlarging the basin here. So this thing is very active.
That last time he came, his friend Jeff Erb shot the drone footage we're using in the video. That's Jeff. You can see how much has changed in about 10 days.
We know immediately it drains into the underlying upper Floridan Aquifer. But ultimately, we don't know the fate of this water. We know that once it gets into the aquifer here, into the limestone, it flows to the south. But interestingly, there are a couple of major springs just south of here, and we don't know enough about how the water moves once it gets into the underlying aquifer to know which one of those springs it might emerge at. So a neat thing to do would be to put some dye into here and then go down gradient and look to see where the dye comes out. And that would give us a better idea, obviously, of how this water is moving through the underlying aquifer.
In another lake, Harley climbed into the aquifer.
When Lake Jackson, for instance, when it went down and completely drained the last time, turns out the sinkhole was associated with a small cave system. So we actually lowered a ladder down into there and we went down and we actually explored and mapped this small cave and we were literally underneath the bed of the lake. Lake Miccosukee is one of the four major lake basins we have here in Leon County. And what you're looking at behind me is this sinkhole. This is actually how those lake basins ultimately formed. So over geologic time, and we're talking, you know, many, many thousands to millions of years, sinkhole activity would occur. And as these sinkholes opened up over time and they would take sediment and water, they would create low spots. More and more sinkhole activity would occur and these sinkholes would coalesce. And over time, they can form these nice big basins. And as you see, this basin is continuing to evolve as are the other major lake basins, like for instance, Lake Jackson and Lake Iamonia. Both of those have active sinkholes in the beds of them, as does Lake Miccosukee. So you're looking at the mechanism behind how these lakes in Leon County form.
To recap,
thank you.
Harry Smith is a kayak guide in Tallahassee. He spends a lot of time on water that might have come from this lake.
It puts it all in perspective. You kind of see it, like I said, happening live in front of you. A lot of people don't realize that where this flows is all interconnected beneath us. And the fact that paddling on the Wasis or the St. Marks is the very same water that you're getting from Lake Miccosukee or Lake Imonia, some of these other lakes around here. So it's all connected and it'll all get back to you one way or another.
For WFSU, I'm Rob Diaz de Villegas.